Welcome. My name is Patrice Bailey. I'm the Dean of Theater at New Old School of the Arts Theater Division. Thank you for joining us for the second night of the One Festival. Each year, the Theater Division requires that our BFA graduating seniors write, produce, direct, and act in their own one-person show. This year, we have 15 seniors, 15 shows, each 15 minutes in length, taking place over three premiere evenings with five shows per program, December 16th, 17th, and 18th. I'd like to take a moment to thank all of our faculty advisors, our special guest artist, Jim Cavalli, our incredible theater production team, and Miami-Dade College Media Services for all of their support to make this year's festival possible. Thank you again for joining us and enjoy the shows.
Thank you, Grinchette, but your understudy will be going on for you. Rose Lou Mayhew!
Excuse me? Oh, haha, you guys. Funny joke, you really got me. Can we get back to rehearsal, though? I was really feeling that one. Oh, you're being serious. You're really gonna replace me with Rose Lou Mayhew? With little Miss Upturned Nose Mayhew? Little Miss Dad's actually a candy cane dealer, but everyone looks away because he's our mayor, Mayhew. And you're all just gonna sit here and let this happen? Okay. Actually, I'm sorry. Do you know how hard it is to pop lock and drop it in this outfit? I have to train for 3 years just to perfect my pop. And if you didn't want to pop, oh, I could have given you a salsa, or a tap, or an Irish jig dance if your heart desired, because I'm a fan-freaking-tastic performer! I'd like to see you try it, Fred. Oh, yeah. I'm talking to you, Fred Winkle, who? Oh, is this about last year's Kringlemeister Eggnogathon? Because I told you, I'm sorry about ruining your carpet. And your table. And your cat, you know, all of this is in the past. And today is a new day. A day in which you can make the right decision for the good of the people. I mean, what will Whoville do when they find out you've replaced the Grinch's daughter? Oh, I expect no less than warfare. They'll try to overthrow the government and we'll all be wearing red berets before you know it. So, do the right thing and let me entertain you. Let me make you smile. Let me do a few tricks, some old and then some new tricks. I'm very versatile. So let me entertain you and we'll have a real good time.
Rose Lou Mayhew, places.
No, Rose. Oh, we wouldn't want you coming out here and hurting yourself. Don't you worry about it. We all know you don't have the best balance. Fifth grade, square dancing, ambulance. Oh, it's probably best you go back into your dressing room and powder your cute little nose. Dressing room. Okay, Fred. I see you've got an every who on your side. Patricia? Dan? Phil? Or are you all into voyeurism now? Okay, I see how it is. Two can play this game. Mark my words, I will not be put into the ensemble!
Get ready for some holiday cheer for who's of all places far and near. Guaranteed to bring you joy and laughter, it's the annual Whoville Christmas Spectacular. Starring Grinch, Rose Lou Mayhew.
Rose Lou Mayhew, you lit up! This is so wrong on so many levels. Now they really want to see me play devil. Why would they do this? I don't know why they would, especially when I look this goddamn good. Oh, you know I'm mad because I'm rhyming. Sweet Santa, where is alcohol when you need it? There must be some here. Oh, stupid garland. Come to Mama. Okay. How to survive this catastrophic event? I can blame the director, say he had a neurotic breakdown. Ooh, ooh, or that Rose Lou Mayhew got her daddy, Mr. Mayor, to buy her the part. But who cares? She's the one that gets to be on the stage seducing every who with Santa Baby. And I'm gonna have to move to the mountains, become a nun, and be resigned to teaching rich children do-re-mi! Oh! What's next? The curse of obesity? Well, I guess this is my life now. People will say, poor Grinchette. She really thought she could be something. Well, damn right I did. But I guess that's something life teaches, huh? Not every who is meant to be something. You know, this is just like the cheer team tryout for the Whoers. Oh, and Whoers they were. I really wanted to be one. Somehow, I didn't get in, even though I was the only one with a matching sparkling outfit, but whatever. It's their loss. Why do I have to look like this? I didn't ask for this. I don't want it. Take it back. This face, and this hair, and this screen. All I ever see is green, green, green. I'm tired. I'm always looking in the mirror and wanting to see something different. And I'm always fighting with myself. No, isn't there anyone better to fight with? Oh, we've got a contender. So you're really just gonna repeat everything I say? I'm ugly! Oh, you little, I'm not talking to you anymore. No wonder my dad hates you. Okay. Okay, let me try something. I love myself. I'm beautiful and worthy. And I'm crazy. I'm crazy. And I'm talented. And this little Mayhew bitch isn't gonna take that away from me. Because guess what, baby? Oh, Miss Grinchette, She's a leading lady. I just thought of the perfect plan. All I need to do is fool the stagehand. I'll sneaky sneak sneak to the side of the wing. Oh, they'll never even suspect a thing. Before they know it, I'll be back on the stage. The audience will be crying with glee and with praise. Ooh, there's that rhyming again. Oh, I hear the audience coming in. Oh, brrr, ma, ma, ma. Mm-hmm. All right, baby. It's showtime. Welcome all to the Whoville Christmas Spectacular! Oh, excuse my sudden emergence. I know you were all expecting to see me sooner. Well, give it up for Miss Rose Lou Mayhew! Oh, she really did try her darnest, but... Aren't you all happy to see me? I know I am. I was ready to come out here and razzle-dazzle you all, but good things come to those who wait. But sometimes waiting just doesn't cut it. All that waiting and waiting becomes exhausting, and you just have to do something. Unlike Rose, who does nothing! Oh, a wag of the finger and Daddy's there. Well, do you all know who my dad is? The Grinch! And you think that would mean something, but... Oh, no, no, Rose. She just gets to sit on her perky little high knee with her gorgeous blue eyes and her porcelain skin. Like, she doesn't even have a mustache! Do you know what it feels like to have to wake up every morning to tweeze your mustache? Oh, no, not nair, sweetie. Individual pluckage. Do you? Do any of you? One more move, Phil, I dare you. Please, 5 more minutes. Thank you. I have worked my whole life for this part. I've watched 22 years of the greatest Who's up on this exact stage, and I finally got it. Little green me got the opportunity to bring joy on our favorite day of the year. And I know, some people don't believe that I really love Christmas or that I'm faking it. Yeah, thanks, Dad, for that reputation. But I grew up in Whoville. Every year, I'd hang up my stockings and mistletoe wreath. We'd feast on Who pudding and rare Who roast beast. Oh, we'd hold hands together and sing all around. Not one single person was sporting a frown. We'd set out our cookies and milk for old Nick, but only D-lactose to avoid any stink. I hold on to these memories like they were yesterday, but slowly I feel them slipping away. These warm, fuzzy thoughts that I hold on to so dearly have turned into hazy, red thoughts that are eerie. My naive young mind, it always wandered to bliss. And it decided that it should choose to dismiss the looks on the faces of my who-made friends, the looks of unwant, unlike, and unblech. A shrug of the arm because my hand was hairy. They'd think, oh, Grinchette, she's so scary. My greenness, my meanness, my grinchiness ways, it didn't win me an invite to ride on the sleighs. I may not have noticed then, but oh, now I do. Yet, we can start fresh with a brand new debut. If we open our eyes and our hearts just a smidge, we'll see that we can gap our own ridge with love and compassion and food and laughter. It won't matter if we're pink, green, black, or alabaster. What I think that Christmas is really about is loving others for who they are, inside and out. And so, for you all who have come here before us in hopes of a Christmas spectacle performance, I'll sing you a song that rings true to me. From my heart to yours, ringy-ding-dee. Phil, thank you.
Shine so bright. Won't you help me give out gifts tonight?
Me? Oh, Santa, I'm your biggest fan! Yes, of course, yes! Suck it, Rose Lou Mayhew! I'm with Santa now, biatch!
If it were possible to fall in love with the moon, I'd say I'm already there. That glare, that shine, it's enticing. It makes the ocean look like you would be safe swimming in it as long as you stayed in the moon's light. Safe. From the other 94% of the ocean that hasn't been discovered yet. It makes me want to dive right in and swim down into the abyss and never come back up. I don't even know if you can hear me. Or if this is something people who have been stranded in the woods for 8 nights start to do when they've lost hope in finding their way out. I don't know anything, really. My mind, it feels like it's being suffocated by emptiness. I wonder if I'm already dead. Shall I lay here wallowing or start cheering? Who's to say that I'm not thinking with the rest of the dead? R.I.P. Fox. Forever in someone's heart. Is that why you brought me here? I'm assuming that you're only here to set the moon and rise the sun. And I hate to interrupt you while you're doing your job, but for the sake of my sanity, I just really want to know something, and I have been dying to ask you since I was a tiny fucking kid when my sister threw me in a dark room, pinned me down to the floor while holding a power drill next to my little fucking kid head! What the fuck, dude? I'm talking to you! Don't think I haven't noticed you watching and listening to me my entire life. I know that you're there because you're always there. Sometimes I can feel you in my bones, tickling them with a feather. I need you to know that I'm onto you. I have wasted hours, lost brain cells, and poisoned my pure conscience with psychedelics just to try and figure out what the fuck is going on between me and you, because it seems like we haven't been seeing eye to eye on this important situation here. Life. You want to know what the reality is? The reality is life means... Are you catching on to my drift? A person gets to decide what they want to do with their life. Some choose to make money, raise a family, and become Disney season annual pass holders. Ah! Which is so fucking pretentious, by the way. Others, for example, the other half of my family, choose to shoot up heroin, drink their livers to death, and leave their wives for younger women they met in rehab. You want to tell me any of that has a significant meaning? You think that I believe that all of this happened for a reason? Oh, no, 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 no. I'm not one of those silly fucking sheep that think that your torment is somehow a valuable lesson. I'm not entirely brain dead yet, so I can understand why people think you're there to guide them through the disasters that come with being a being. But it's because they have to make sense of it all. Serial killers, postpartum depression, touchy uncles. Like, who the fuck came up with that shit? This version of your little simulation is filled with people who feel nothing but ashamed for the things they have no control over. And instead of helping them, you make them feel entirely responsible. Being traumatized feels like there's bolded words branded on my forehead, because it seems like every person I meet somehow already knows that I've been scarred. And the more you pick at it, the longer it takes to fucking get over yourself and just thank the gods for letting you see another day. It means something. Plays in our minds like a broken record while we contemplate waterboarding ourselves with a shower head. I have to remind myself that whoever finds me dead will find me naked. And I've been hiding a nipple piercing from my mom for 2 years, and if I were to die naked, she'd definitely see it. Imagine her running up the stairs and screaming, "Ah, que te pasó, mi pichurrita?" And as she whips open the shower curtain, she'll see me lying on the white ceramic bathtub, sopping wet. And as she turns me over to check my pulse, she'll notice a sparkling metal ball poking out of my right nipple, drop me like a hot potato, and the first thing she'll say to herself is, "Damn it! It's because of the weed!" The only reason why I haven't killed myself yet is because my sister beat me to it. I asked my mom how it felt to have both of her children wanting to die, and she told me that she tried to kill herself when she was only 7 years old. Then she said, "Can you imagine being that young and ready to die?" I'm not gonna kill myself, Francis. I feel like the name Francis suits you. Franny, I'll be honest with you, because I admire your determination to slowly ruin mankind, and I wish you well on your journey. Hear me out. I know, it sounds like if I could, I would suffocate you with a pillow in your sleep. But really, I just hate the fact that there is no winning when I'm matched against you. And the idea of needing to praise you in order to be free terrifies me, because it feels like there's this ongoing exchange happening between us, and I can't live my life feeling like I owe you something. From the time that I was born, you tried keeping me beneath myself by kicking me out of the womb an entire month before I was due, and made sure that my lungs were filled with water so that I could always know what it's like to be alive, but not able to breathe. You want to know my favorite thing about you? I love how you can easily tear somebody apart, strip them entirely, which requires them to sew their skin back together all by themselves. But never having the guts to show them who you really are. But I feel like I do. I feel like I've known you my whole life. I'm even convinced that it's you who lives inside the back, depositing your wasteful thoughts into my voice box. You told me that I should say fuck you to my mom and that I hope I die in a car crash right before I went on this trip. You know how I know that's not me talking when I get like that? Because it always feels like someone else, you can even say it's a demon, eating my thoughts and then projectile vomit to them like pure acid onto my mother's heart. And I feel like a shameful bastard because the poor woman already blames herself for my sister's death when you and I both know that she didn't die because she wanted to. Her soul was devoured by you! My mom's probably dreaming about this as we speak. Mommy, if you can hear me, I hope I get to play your daughter in every life after this. Well, here the fuck I am, paying for something I technically asked for. All thanks to you. I'm allowed to say life means nothing, because if it meant something, then that means that I wasn't meant for greatness. Instead, I am cursed, and I refuse to let that define me. How could I have been made to only self-destruct? Go ahead! Strike me with your hottest bolt of lightning and fry me like a Krabby Patty! Your sunrise is beautiful, by the way. They always remind me of that one Beatles song. It's like, yourself on a boat on a river with tangerine trees and marmalade skies. I mean, I've always been so confused as to why I was put here in the first place. I don't belong to this. To this life, this dimension. I know that there's something else out there for me! What was I saying? I don't know. But sometimes, I think we're soulmates, baby. And I think the reason why you've been treating me so poorly is because you're in love with me. Yeah, it's as if you've been trying to get me to end it all just so that I can meet you on the other side. You want me all to yourself, don't you? Well, my mother's always told me that you'll know when a man wants you. I'm not here to assume your gender or anything, but it would make sense if God wasn't a woman, because men can never fail to disappoint. I'm intrigued by your obsession with my misery, and I'm dying to make our ends meet. I'm ready to feel at home, and I have this urge that it's with you. Something is telling my soul that this is it. And if the absence of desire leads you to other things, then this is exactly where I'm meant to be.
Gentlemen, live from Caesar Palace Place in Las Vegas on the final stop of his Make Romance Great Again worldwide sold-out tour, please welcome Cupid Valentine!
Thank you. 2,054 shows later, I am so glad to be with you all on the final night of my Make Romance Great Again worldwide sold out tour. My name is Cooper Valentine, but you might know me as Cupid, the Greek god of love and desire. I know you were probably expecting a fat blonde baby wearing a diaper with the powers to make someone fall in love, but don't worry, the only thing that has changed is my hair. I am so happy to be with you all celebrating my favorite day of the year, Valentine's Day. Now, I know what you're thinking. You probably think that it is my favorite day because it is named after me. Well, yes. But besides that, it is my favorite day because I am in love with love. And oh boy, do I feel the love tonight. I'm not talking about cheap chocolates or the car that your husband got you the night before from your local Walmart. I'm talking about real love, the love that you can't just find anywhere. Real love still exists and it is out there waiting for you. And you can read all about it by purchasing my New York Times bestselling book, The Truth About Love, now available at www.cupidvalentine.com. I myself have found a kind of love, so I'm happily married to the love of my life. And look, I don't mean to brag, but we invented being the it couple. I mean, what do you get when the most beautiful woman in the world meets the most handsome guy in the world? Children, so don't get married. Tonight, we'll play our very own game of love, and a lucky, deserving couple will get a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to have their marriage officiated by none other than me, the Greek god of love and desire. Okay, can we please turn those off? It's very distracting. Great, let's try that again. Tonight, we'll play our very own game of love, and a lucky, deserving couple will get a once-in-a-lifetime... Did y'all miss a three-minute announcement at the top of the show? Hi, at this moment, please take out your phones and make sure that they're turned off. And oh, it's me, isn't it? I'll just go ahead and turn this off, so I should have. This is funny. This is really funny. Who did this? I have to say, they made it look a lot like me, but it's not me. Wow, the kids are getting great at Photoshop these days, right? Let's just go ahead, put our phones away, and we can... Why are y'all staring at me like that? You don't actually believe that it is me, right? It doesn't even look like me. Do you see his nose? It looks like he has Shrek's nose. Are you saying that I have Shrek's nose? And that hair looks like it hasn't been washed in days? And look, this person has a birthmark behind my ear. I don't have a birthmark behind my ear. Do you see anything? Plus, who even posted this? TMZ, really? Greek god of love and desire, blah, 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 has been seen kissing a man, what? In an image seen by 4 million people in just 5 minutes? 5 million people? One of you fuckers sent this to 5 million people? Do you understand that you assholes have spread fake news to 5 million people? One of those 5 million people is my wife, my daughter, my parents, my family, my fans, my boss. I could lose my job over this shit. That is not me in the picture. It's disgusting that you think that a man like me would do something like that. I swear, whoever did this is gonna hear... Okay, you guys have been a great audience. Let's keep it up. I'm gonna go grab a coffee and I probably won't come back, but thanks for coming.
Cupid! Oh,
Dad, what are you doing here?
What do you think I
do? Oh, Dad, it's not what it looks like.
Is that you with
me? No, it isn't me, I promise.
And you're never lying to a god. Are you trying to ruin me? I sent you to do me a favor, and now you have embarrassed us all.
Father,
what are you doing with your life?
Father, please calm down. I
Do you take me for a fool? I pray this day would never come. My son, a faggot. A selfish faggot. I'm going to ask you one last time. Is that you in the picture?
Can we stop the music? Yes. But it was an accident. I didn't intend for it to happen.
Stop lying to me! I wish you could see your mother and your wife crying. This show is finished. You are to never step into the gates of Olympus ever again. Do you hear me? Do you hear me? You are not my son.
Father, wait, I promise I won't do it again. I just want my life back, please. I'll donate all my money, I'll read the Bible. I'll shave my head. Wait, not that one. I fucked everything up. My career, my parents, my wife. Oh, what now? My entire life, everyone has been so damn judgmental. I'm not stupid. I always knew I was different. You figure those things out when you're getting beat up and called names as a kid. I was too feminine. I hung out with the girls for too long. I hated sports. I was gay, according to the boys in my class. God, I hate that word. I didn't even know what it meant, but just the filth in their mouth made it seem like it was worse than killing someone. And it became a question I was asked almost every single fucking day. Are you gay? Are you gay? Are you gay? I didn't even know how to tie my shoes yet. And I couldn't tell my parents that I was being bullied because they would just blame it on me. I was the problem! I have always been the problem. And maybe they knew. And just like I did, chose to deny it. Being a faggot, as my father so beautifully described it, was never really an option for me. You see, my father is a god of war and my mother is a goddess of love, and all is fair in love and war, but not having a gay son. But I love them. And love makes you do some dumb things like marrying someone just to make my parents happy. And did you know that I had to use one of my arrows to fall in love with her? Love hurts, am I right? My wife Psyche, the most beautiful woman in this whole universe, wasted on a man that wasn't attracted to her. And I really do love you, Psyche. I just, why am I like this? And you know, I actually thought it would work. I thought it would fix me, but love becomes powerless in the absence of truth. Chapter 27 in my book. I'll never forget my wedding day. Looking over at my parents with the biggest smile on their face, finally their son had done something right. Meanwhile, all I could think to myself is, what the fuck am I doing? I knew I would never make her happy, and not even in the bedroom. And we tried many, many, many times, but to be very honest with you all, I'm scared of vaginas. I can't explain it. But I would just tell her that I had some sort of erectile dysfunction, and we both wanted a kid. So we adopted our daughter. I betrayed them both. I had never done anything with a guy. I had thoughts about it, but never in a million years would I think that it would actually happen. But I traveled a lot for work, and the opportunity appeared in front of me. That night, it all made sense. It was just euphoric. Oliver, you all have been in love before. You have to know what I mean, that rapid heartbeat and those never-ending butterflies that let you know that you could spend the rest of your life with them. Have you ever wondered why Valentine's Day is on February 14th? It was the day we met. The day I finally understood what love meant. My wings never did this for her. I loved him so much, but I didn't give myself permission to be loved. You see, I give and I give and I give so much love to everyone, but when it comes to me, it always feels like I don't deserve it. And I don't. So after 3 years, a couple of work trips, and living a double life, I knew I had to end things with him. And I did. Only two people had possession of that image you all received tonight. Me and him. I feel like I should be upset, but in a way I'm glad. And look, I'm not trying to throw myself a pity party. I know I deserve this. I don't know where to go from here. My entire life, I was taught that being who I wanted to be was wrong. And maybe I'm scared to not be the perfect guy that everyone always makes me seem. But why am I so scared? Why do I deny myself happiness when I deserve it just as much as everybody else? Why do others like me get to live happily while I'm stuck in this nightmare? I fucked up. I know I did. But I also know that although I did some bad things, I am not a bad person. And I no longer care about what anyone else has to say because it is my time to live my life. Love me for who I am, not for who you want me to be. I am smart. I am caring. I am sensitive. I am strong. I am romantic. I'm caring. I'm gay. I'm gay. I'm gay, goddammit! I'm still me.
Ladies and gentlemen, live from Caesar Palace Place in Las Vegas, on the final stop of his Make Romance Great Again worldwide sold-out tour, please welcome Cupid Valentine!
My name is Cupid Valentine. I have brown hair and hazel eyes. I am 5'11" and I weigh 160 pounds when I'm happy and 165 pounds when I am miserable. Right now I am 163 and my future is in your hands. So let's make sure we have a great show. We have an incredible show planned for you all, but before we begin, I would like to dedicate the show to all the Cupids out there. It takes some insight and intelligence to know that you're gay. And then a tremendous amount of balls to live it and live it proudly. A year ago, I was embraced by a new community. That's what happens when you're finally honest with yourself. You find others like you. So tonight, like every night, we celebrate love. Because love is love.
Come in.
There you are. He was such a pleasure to kill. You know, nothing tastes better than perverted bastards who die quaking in fear. Well, a deal's a deal. Now, where is it? Oh, I see. You don't want to give it to me. You know, there is nothing I detest more than being stolen from. I have to cast that spell tonight, Lance. I don't have time for your stupid games. Now, where is the ring? Oh, speak up. I think you might have a crushed windpipe. Here, let me help you. Oops. Did you have any idea what a miserable shit you were? You were just too easy to track down. I could smell the stink of alcohol and testosterone on you from 5 miles away. And when I get to you, what do I find? Some sleazy drunkard taking advantage of a 14-year-old girl. You're lucky I only cut off the head attached to your neck. Ugh, never mind this. You're dead and I'm in need of what I came for. Show me where it is. Oh, how useful that direct line to hell is. Thank you, demons. Do you see this? This is my husband's ring. I've been hunting him down for 200 years. And he put quite the curse on me. You see, when you are turned, your mind always goes back to him. The curse of the vampire. Immortality. Bound to him. You humans would think immortality is a gift.
You feared death so much, you pissed yourself. Believe you me, you are very lucky to have died. He cut my dreams of growing old by the countryside, having grandchildren. Do you see this? 2 goddamn centuries bound to you, and now I have you! The circles you had me running, trying to find you, I must admit, bravo. I searched through all the circles of hell, through all of purgatory, I nearly tore half of Europe apart. Come to find you were here, wandering the human world. Oh, and the best part, with new wives to serve you. Wives. Adding poor women to your harem of bloodthirsty whores does not make them wives. You only have 1 wife, lad, and I still have my ring. I finally have everything I need for the summoning spell. By midnight, you'll be dead and I'll be free. I wonder what your face might look like in your final moments. Will I see sorrow, fear, regret? I'll have my answer soon. You'd think after 200 years, the curse would wear off and I'd feel nothing for you, but I still feel it. And I've tried to break it and move on with someone, anyone. Well, maybe not anyone. Just somebody that could help me forget even for a moment about you, but your wretched curse won't let me. You took my chance at a normal life. You took a girl in her youth and you turned me into this. This monster. Have you any recollection of what you said when you convinced me to transform?
I cannot believe you have such little faith in me. You'd think me, your husband, capable of misleading you. You don't trust me!
No, it's not that.
A loyal wife would let me. If you really loved me, you'd do this.
You know my heart. I am loyal to you always. But the word of God says that there is a time to live and a time to die.
God would want us to do this. God would want us to be together forever. You should trust me. I am closer to God than you are.
I should have said no. I should have fought harder. But I didn't. And I let you. The life was drained out of me. There was no longer a me. There was only you. 2 weeks later, you disappeared. I had given up my humanity, betrayed my faith for you. Everything I did for you. And what was I? Some tool in your scheme to use and throw away? No more. You took my entire life. Time to return the favor. Well, you can stay and watch. For now. I had to tear that wretched castle apart, stone by stone, to find this one. My human virgin hair. I gave this to you on Christmas Eve. The night was dark and the snow had freshly fallen. Oh, I am terribly sorry, my prince. Oh no, the ball was lovely, it's just that. Well, if I am to be truthful, my lord, I grew weary of watching all those noble ladies try to win you over. If you are meant to be my husband, then it shall come to fruition. No need to throw myself at your heels. So stunned at the idea of a woman not throwing herself at your feet. You swore you needed something to remember me by, a memento of this night until we met again. And were so enamored with my hair. I love that arrogant child that I was. Wild and free as the wind, until you and your charming tongue. A charmer who had a way with words, like our wedding vows. Dragostea mea, viata mea, draga mea. My love, my life, my darling. With this ring, I promise to make you mine in this life and the next. For all eternity, I will love you beyond death, and our love will transcend lifetimes. Oh, what an actor. What a poet. Do you even remember our wedding day?
I remember everything. I was so happy. Such a happy, romantic, naive little girl. I remember your raven hair and dark eyes. They seemed to glow with the light of the stained glass of the cathedral. I remember the way you looked at me. I had never had a man speak so tenderly to me. Everything you said was like honey in my ear. I wonder if you ever meant any of it. My mother gave this to me on our wedding day. The most precious gift I had ever received. One day, you came in and snatched the cross from my neck.
Your prayer time is taking up too much time, Elisabeta. When I come home, your attention needs to be on me. Haven't I earned that?
Yes, my lord.
You aren't close to God. I am. You don't need prayer. You need me. You don't need this.
No! After you broke it, do you remember what you said? I will not waste my time crossing oceans for someone who wouldn't jump mere puddles for me. What ocean had I not crossed? What hadn't I given you, Vlad? I was completely isolated. I never saw my mother, my friends, and now I couldn't speak to God, and it still wasn't enough for you? It never was. If only you could see me now, God. Your faithful little Elisabeta, damned for all eternity. Even if the curse is lifted and I'm allowed a mortal death, then what? You'll open the golden gates for me? After all I've done? I'm beyond saving. Yes! Now the human sacrifice. You are finally of use to someone. Congratulations.
Yo, Elisabeta de Targovista, combo convocare, prinsul Transylvania, prinsul inteniericuli, iese, ridicate din flacarili, dragostea morta, simfrunta, disuarta.
What? Where is he? Vlad Dracul Tepes, show yourself. I know you are here. Why did it not work?
You are nothing without me.
Need me.
Dragostea
mia. You want to kill me? You're marked by
shut
me.
Up.
No
one will
ever
stop.
Transcend life to
no.
Stay loyal
no.
To me.
No! Shut up! Do you remember what it felt like to be human, Vlad? I can barely remember what snow feels like, what warmth feels like, exhaustion. The last time I felt tired was on our wedding night, spent next to you on our satin sheets, calling the servants to bring us chocolates because we were starving. And they were awful. But we ate them anyway. Humans are selfish with short, fragile lives, but we never rest. Humans live meaningful lives full of pain, joy, love, sorrow. They feel. I envy them. I miss the feeling of sunshine on my skin. Rest. The evening breeze. You. I miss you. you. You've been here this whole time. You've...
Jesus, you scared the shit out of me. I'm glad to know you know what emergency key means. Okay, you're right. This is kind of an emergency, and I am glad to see you. Just send a text next time, would ya? And you could have at least had the decency to pour me a glass. Hey, I was calling to... What? No, I do trust you. I just... This is important. I need to make sure that she is there on time. It's not going to be a long ceremony. What? No, my daughter cannot skip the pictures. Oh, I swear to God, if you fed her something messy and there is a stain on that dress... Do you see what I deal with? Okay, you know what? Just be there on time and I will have a tied to-go pen. Okay. Yes, I love you. Bye. I know. I shouldn't still love my ex-husband, but I can't help it, okay? Okay, don't judge me for choosing too many. I can return the ones that I don't like. You know, I just keep the tags on them. Hey, it is not wrong if you never wear it in public. And don't even act like I didn't get that from you. Okay, let's see. Which one best fits false bride helping someone to stay in the country? Please don't catch us. Oh, who am I kidding? Which one do you like best? Really? This one, this is my least favorite one. Whatever, it's worth a try. You know, for the record, I knew you were going to choose this specific dress. Oh God, my feet are killing me. You know, why is it that men, they get comfy shoes and deep pockets and what do we get? Oh, we get blisters and purses. How nice. Okay. Wow. Okay, you were right. This is good. I actually like it. Just bridal enough to look like we really love each other. Cheers. Oh, damn it! What do they say to get a stain out? Baking soda and vinegar, thank you. Okay, baking soda. Oh, you gotta be fucking kidding me. Ouch! What did I use vinegar for? How can this be empty? Of course. And this is soaking. You know, I should have known that this process was not gonna be that easy. Oh no, of course not. Not with me. God. Uh,
You know what? This is gonna have to do. It gets oil out of baby ducks. It should get wine out of dresses, right? Mixed with a little bit of that should make some sort of chemical reaction, right? Oh, God. Oh, it's hot. Do you mind turning down the thermostat? What? Don't look at me like that. I am trying to quit, can't you see? It's no big deal. It's just a couple of puffs. You know, I am in control. I am. That doesn't mean anything. Okay. What do you think of this one? Really? That much? Oh, you're a liar. What? Don't look at me like that. This dress was hideous. And besides,
I gotta stop smoking.
Let's just, let's do something else. You know, like these interview questions. These are important. You know, I can decide what to wear after. I've still got 30 minutes. Okay. You turned down the air, right? You know what? It is fine. The bride is always late. Quiz me. Okay. Seriously? That's a question? How is the toilet paper presented? Over or under? What kind of bullshit question is that? Next. Does Abraham have chest hair? I mean, he should. He's Syrian. Okay, you're right. That was racist. I'm sorry. But I'm still gonna go with yes. All right, I'm on a roll. Keep him coming. How long have we been living together? This is where I talk about Christmas and how we moved in together on our first Christmas. He gave me a little wrapped box with the key in it. And then I show them our phony Christmas pictures that were actually taken in like the middle of summer. Okay, next one. Give me a hard one, like how did you two meet? I hate that question because the truth is he was a random stranger who happened to work with my ex and mentioned he was getting deported in 3 days. And I blurted out, I'll marry you. We ended up talking the whole night. He thought I was messing with him. I can't believe we have to go through all of this. Right, but the question, the answer to the question is, he was working with my ex-husband and I would go to pick up my daughter, Hope. I noticed Abraham and he caught my eye, so I started to get dolled up and go more often, hoping he would notice me. But how did he ask me out? No, don't tell me. Damn it. Okay, you know what? Fine, just tell me now and we'll go over it again later. Oh, here we go. It's Mom. Don't worry, I won't tell her you're here. Hi, Mommy. No, I am excited to hear from you. I just...
Look, honey, I know this is not what you want to be hearing, but I just need to make sure you are making the right decision. You have not known this man for a long time, and I don't know if I can trust this. I gained citizenship on my own. Not to mention, I came from Cuba, not Africa.
Jesus, Mother! He is from Syria.
Oh, great. So he's a refugee.
As if you weren't either. You know what? Everyone is from somewhere, and he's a very nice person. So what does it matter? I am marrying him. I'm sorry. I'm under a lot of pressure, okay? All right. I love you too. Bye. How did I get into this? Oh, yes, because I put everybody else's needs before my own. You know what? When I told you about this, why didn't you stop me? You're supposed to be my big sister. You're right. That's not fair. It's not your fault that I have this overwhelming need to take care of all of humanity. So why is that so hard, God, huh? You know, like what happens to good always prevails and shit? You know, because what feels right is considered breaking the law. And what law? I plant flag, this land mine. Ugh. Like, I just feel that this is my one person to help. It's going to be okay, right? I mean, why would they have any reason to suspect us? We've answered all of their questions. We went through their whole process. Why would they have any reason to suspect us, right? Or is that when they get you? What can happen if you get... I don't know if Googling it could get me in trouble. Well, yeah, that's how killers get caught. I'm not a killer. Green card. Okay. www.ice.gov, that's official, says marriage fraud is a federal crime. Well, yeah, we know that, but what's the penalty? Jesus, there's a tip line? So you're telling me that anybody, just any old person, can decide that they suspect us and report it? Okay, penalties. Up to 5 years in prison? I couldn't even last a weekend in jail, you know. And you better not have told Mom about that still. Oh, plus just a $250,000 fine. Like, where do you come up with that kind of money? You know what? Hear me out. I just gotta remember why I'm doing this, right? Okay. I can't mess myself up thinking about the risks, because he's risking more than I am, you know? If we get caught, he has to go back to Syria. I mean, you know what's going on there, right? War. Like, full-out war. Their country is in shambles. Their people are hungry and dying and homeless. If he goes back, his death is my fault. I have to do this. Yeah, it's what Jesus would do, I think. I mean, I'm sure Jesus was never put in this situation, and I know Jesus was never married, but that is besides the point. I know in my soul this is the right thing to do. Okay, the risk is worth it. I can do this. Let's go get me married. Oh my God, look at me. I can't do this. Do you hear me? I'm talking about crime like it's a good thing. I'm not even getting paid for this. You know, most people get paid for this, right? How am I supposed to pay that $250,000 if I'm not even getting paid? Hope. I can't do this to Hope. I could go to jail and I would miss all the good years. She would be 12 by the time I got out. Oh no, 12 is the age that girls turn to bitches. No, no, I'd miss all the sweet years. She'd stop calling me mommy and say things like, I hate you and you ruined my life and fuck you, bitch. I'm not going. I can't go. You know, maybe Abraham can find some other way to get his green card. I am not totally screwing him. It's him. Oh, fuck.
Thank you for joining us for tonight's performance. Please take a moment to consider giving to our Friends of Theater campaign. Your donations go directly to the division's production needs, purchasing costumes, sets, props, and hiring choreographers, designers, video, and sound engineers. Have a wonderful evening, and hopefully we'll see you in the theater soon.